Very good morning, one and all. We are learning the subject of antenna and wave propagation. And in this subject already, we have studied about the unit number one, chapter number one, that was on the uniform plane wave. Already we have discussed. Today we will continue with the chapter number two, wave propagation. So in this subject, that is antenna and wave propagation, so we will go for the how the wave propagation will happen, what is the role of that, okay, and which things or which parameters will be affect on that wave propagation while the signals are traveling. If we are having the transmitting and the receiving antennas, what will be the effect of that? There are many parameters that affect on the, what we can say, the when the wave will be propagate from one place to the another place, because we are taking the major application is nothing but your the antenna. So if you are talking about the antenna, definitely these things are matters, because we are also, the medium is the free space. So from one place to the another place, if the signals are traveling in such a cases, two huge amount of the parameters will be affected, and that will be required for measurement, or what you can say, at the time of measuring, at the time of designing that antenna. So it's a very useful, okay. So we will start the session on the chapter number two, that is the wave propagation in the subject of antenna and wave propagation. Once again, welcome you all. So chapter number two. Wave propagation. So the content in this chapter, the wave propagation chapter, the contents are the fundamental equation for the free space propagation, the Faraday's transmission equation, the attenuation over the reflecting surface, the effect of earth curvature, how the ground, sky and the space wave propagate, structure of the atmosphere, characteristics of the ionized region, because we are talking about the free space and all. So effect of earth magnetic field, virtual height, MUF, skip distance, the ionospheric abnormalities, multi-hop propagation, space link geometry, characteristics of the wireless channel spreading, multipath delay spread, coherence bandwidth and the coherence time, for latecomers, I'm going to repeat once again. So chapter number two is going to start today, that is the wave propagation. And in the wave propagation, few contents are there. The contents are listed here. The fundamental equations, the attenuator, the Faraday's transmission equation, the effect of earth curvature, the character structure of ionization, the skip distance, the virtual height, the multi-hop propagation, likewise, the space link geometry. There are a lot of parameters. The content you can see in the chapter number two. So one by one, we will go through it. Okay, so we will start with the first thing, that is nothing but the introduction. So in the introductory part of your the antenna, that is antenna is a transistor, one type of transistor that converts the radio frequency of your the electric current to the electromagnetic wave that are radiated into the space, that we are aware by this definition already. So in the two-way communication, the same antenna can be used for the transmission and reception, that also we are aware. We are required the two antennas, one at the transmitting side and one at the receiving side. Okay, and in between that, the wave will be propagate travels. Okay, and we are interested how that wave will be propagate, and at the base station or at the ground station also there will be the controlling station. So at that place also we need to take care about all the parameters while connected to the antennas. Similarly, at the receiving point where the controlling station is there, so that time also the parameters will be required. So So the next is the fundamental concept related to this antenna is nothing but we are interested in the reciprocity theorem that we are aware we have studied in the network analysis. Reciprocity is why in the reciprocity? Because already we know whenever we are changing the source to the destination and the destination to the source, that the sources, that is in terms of the voltage and the current, the meaning should not be changed. If voltage is replaced by the current and the current is replaced by the voltage, if the voltage is at the source side and next time that will be replaced at the destination side, and the destination side, if the current source is there and replaced at the source side, the meaning should not be changed even though we are changing the sides. Okay. Only for our simplification, for the mathematical modeling, we require such things. So next parameter most widely essential, that is the radiation patterns, in that we are interested in the isotropic radiator, because one of the type of antenna is the, what we can say, the isolator antenna, okay, isotropic antenna. So next parameter is nothing but the gain, which is also too important while we are learning about the antenna. Next is nothing but the polarization, little bit concept are clear about the polarization, which we have studied in the last session. So what is the reciprocity? In the general, various properties of an antenna applies the equal regardless of the current and the voltage distribution is important, as well as the impedance is important. So be remember, while we are talking about the reciprocity, it means that we are interested the term efficiency, which is related to the transmission and reception of the signals. Next is nothing but the gain. Next is nothing but the current voltage or distribution. How much amount of the voltage and the current that is at the source and the destination side, or the transmission and reception side. Likewise, the impedance also we are interested. All these things, parameters, is too important while we are designing the antenna. Similarly, in the radiation patterns, while we are studying, so we are interested in the radiation pattern, that is nothing but the graphical representation of the radiation properties of an antenna. Means how that is represented related to that graphical diagram. Because if you observe, see here the shape, how the shape is in the circular form, in the elliptical form, whether it is in the linear form, whatever. And how many direction of the vectors are affecting on that, and how they can be located, how they can be placed, depending on their location, they will charge the signals, and accordingly, at the reception side, that signal will be received by the particular antenna. We know very well few antennas will be the common in the circular way, so they can catch all the surrounding signals. Many times, on a particular direction side, many will be the back side, many things will be the top and the bottom. Likewise, it's totally depend upon the how you are locating your antenna. Okay. Next is nothing but the reception patterns. Transmitting side, how you are going to locate, and the other is nothing but your the reception side. How receiving antennas will be equivalent to the radiation patterns. So radiation patterns means how you are placed as per their pattern, only the signal will be. Okay. So in the radiation pattern, see here, one of the example, might be you have seen such type of antennas who are in the villages, or maybe in the your parents, they are aware by this antennas. Okay, so this antennas showing the the patterns, radiation patterns, how that power will be radiate. Okay, so these patterns are nothing but the beam patterns. Okay, and how horizontal, vertical, or you can say in the magnetic field and electric field, how they can be placed. See here, this is the small structure is in the circular form, how they can be rotate, place, locate. Okay, so this is the shape of your the radiation pattern. See the pattern. Okay, and see here likewise, how they can catch the entire term, this section they will catch, and that section is nothing but the half power beam width. That section is nothing but half power beam width. So beam width or the half power beam width, that is the same thing. We are interested how long the distance is there. We are interested how they can be radiate, so that information or the signal can be transmit and receive through the antennas. Okay. Because we know very well the radiation pattern which is coming here in the magnetic as well as the electric fields. Okay, so in this way, we are interested how long they can be propagate, how long they can be radiate, and with the help of this beam width, we can find so and so is the width of that sicknesses, radiation sicknesses, and we can find easily. If you observe this antenna, okay, so in this antenna, one thing, the plates which are in the horizontal form, we can see that is in the electric field they are showing, and the plates here, the small plates, in the other direction, they are showing the magnetic field. So whenever we are plotting the graph, we are aware on the axis, what we can say, if we are talking about the X, Y, and the Z, so we can assume anything, X, Y, and the Z. One will be the, showing the direction of the magnetic, one will be electric, and other will be in which particular direction the radiation is going on. So this antenna is showing how the electric field, in which field they are going, how the magnetic field in which direction. So totally depend upon the place, how you are locating this antenna. The gain is also one of the important parameter in the antenna designing. So it's nothing but the power output in the particular direction compared to that produced in any direction by an isotropic antenna. It means that we are aware the power is nothing but the output divided by the input, or you can find easily how much amount of the power will be delivered by the particular thing if you are applying the so-and-so input thing. So how you are gaining, okay? So this is important. That is nothing but the power output is important. Effective area, that is related to the physical size and the shape of the antenna. If wherever the antenna is placed, on that particular antenna, nearby area matters, which is nothing but the physical size and the shape of that antenna. How long is your antenna? How you are placing the antenna? What is exactly the size, the width, the height of your the antenna? And depending upon that, you can find easily the effective area of that particular antenna. Polarization, so in this case, we know very well the orientation of the electric field, that is the E-plane of the magnetic wave. In terms, you can say polarization, there are a lot of, what you can say, the types of polarization, that is a linear, in that linear, horizontal, and the vertical, circular, elliptical. Already we have studied about the polarization, various types, the vertical, horizontal, polarized, vertical, polarized. Okay, here the examples are also mentioned here. Broadcast tower of the AM radio are come under the category of the vertical polarized antenna. How they are placing, how the signals are polarized, depending upon the application, you can say, or that particular application needs such type of polarization or the wave propagation or the signal transmission. If you go for the next application, that is a horizontal form, so that is nothing but the television transmission line. Okay, similarly in the circular also, there will be the combination of electric as well as the magnetic fields in the particular planes. Okay, and this first type of thing, how the polarization happens, how the horizontal and vertical, what we can say, the planes act, how that wave will be, the wave and the signals can be traveled, that is in this polarization figure. In that, we are interested in the wavelength. Okay, this is the wavelength. Okay, here we are interested in the relay. That is nothing but in terms of the radiance. Other is nothing but the magnitude of your the E field, that is missing in terms of the volt per meter. Again, the E field orientation, that is the polarization. See here the shapes and how they are traveling. So this vertical is nothing but the magnetic field, and this horizontal, you can see, is the, or we can say the electric field. They will be changed every time when you, just like with the sinusoidal waveform. The sinusoidal waveform is changing, the direction of these two will be changed every time. So that's what we are taking every time. It's a cross product, that is the E cross of H. So a linear, if we are talking about the linear polarization, it means that indirectly we are talking about the vertical and horizontal thing. And if you're talking about the circular form, means that the right and the left hand side we are considering every time. So in this way, this direction is showing the direct propagation direction of the energy fluxes, that's measured in terms of the watt per meter square. So types of antennas, there are various types of antennas are there. So isotropic antenna is one of the type of antenna, in that the ideal and the radiated power is nothing but the equal to all the directions. So one of the example of here, the radiated power is nothing but the omnidirectional. Okay, there and in all direction that showed. You can say in the many cars also on the top there will be the, you will find one of the antenna. Okay, so such type of antenna, even walkie talkie is also one of the antenna, just like the strip. So that is under the category of omnidirectional. The dipole antenna, in that the half wave dipole antenna as well as the quarter wave vertical antenna. So this is totally depend upon the how they the radiation pattern And secondly, why? Because the half wave propagating means how they are radiating. So they are radiating half wave, and they are radiating quarter wave. So likewise, the name itself indicating how they are radiating, and as for that only the name indication, this is so-and-so antenna. And secondly, it's nothing but depending upon application. So in many cases, they require the half wave only. In many cases, they require the quarter wave only. And next is nothing but the parabolic reflector antenna. So I will show you that the design part of the parabolic very soon in the next slide. So what is the mean by this, the dipole antenna? So see here, this is the circular shape, and you are aware, if you're talking about the longitudinal, you were talking about the azimuth angle, elevation angle, or these are nothing but the patterns, how the antenna is placed. So the center part is nothing but the azimuth angle, okay, and these are nothing but the elevation, two-sided, the Z and the Y direction, you can observe easily. So the one gives the azimuth patterns is also there, how they are opposite. See here the elevation, and see here the azimuth angle. Similarly here, the half section, these are the slits, upper portion, bottom portion. Okay, middle they are cross. So the upper portion is in the same with your the X direction cross. So this upper section is nothing but the half dipole. This is again the half. Whatever is the total length, that will be half. Because if you're talking about total length is my lambda, so definitely this half will be lambda by 2. This half will be lambda by 2. Total is nothing but my lambda is my length. Total length L is equal to lambda. But if I'm talking about the upper portion, so definitely that will be half. So lambda by 2 upper portion. And that secondly, other lambda by 2. So why we are talking this, why we are dividing this lambda wavelength? Just because in a particular direction, whether you want the half, what we can say, wave, whether you want quarter, whether you want full, so totally depend how you are placing your antenna for the radiation, for the location. Then only it is possible to find out that wavelength, as for that wavelength, the signals will be radiated, your location, the dimensions, and depending upon the application. Because every antenna doesn't give fulfill the requirement of all. So if I'm using for the television, means that particular antenna will be used for the particular television only, for the broadcasting television. If something in the radio, for the radio only, okay. So, and as for that only, we are placing, we are designing, we are locating, deciding that directions of that particular antenna. So here, one more thing is important. That point is nothing but you are the radiated power or power radiation, okay. Because ultimately, we are talking about the gain and the efficiency at the end, okay. So these things are important, that is nothing but the radiated power. How that different kinds of mode of your the propagation, how my wave can be propagated, what are the modes, what are the types, what are the methods. So one is nothing but the ground wave propagation, other is nothing but the sky wave propagation, and third is nothing but the line of sight propagation. Because we know, we are aware that the stations, the power, what you can say, the earth on the earth station, the transmitting station as well as the receiving station, it does not place the straight line, because the earth is not, we know very well this is just like a straight, it's just the elliptical circular shape we assume. And as for that only, while traveling from the one place to the far mil kilometers or so far, so it's very difficult to identify whether my path is a straight or what, okay. So a few things, if we are talking about the ground to the space, so definitely sky wave may be propagated from ground to ground is the transmitting. So there will be other line of sight, means hills, the rivers, or the long, what is the hills are there, and any other distance at the time, you need to think about the line of sight propagation in such a case. So the ground wave propagation, see here, what is going on at one side, one tower, which is related to you are the transmit antenna, and other is nothing but the receiving antenna, and this is the earth. So from transmitting to the receiving antenna, the signal will be propagated. So here the follow contour of the wave can be propagated, and the consider the distances, obviously the frequency ranges will be up to the 2 megahertz. The example of this one is nothing but the AM radio waves. Okay, whenever we are talking about the application of the radio waves, so that is come under the category of mode, that is nothing but the ground wave propagation, in that transmitting and receiving at the far distances. The frequency range will be lies in between the 2 megahertz. Next is nothing but the sky wave propagation. In the sky wave propagation, the signals will be reflected from the ionized layer of the atmosphere back down to the earth. So we know very well, once we move ahead from the earth, there are a various, after few kilometers there in the space, there are a various layers. Okay, ionic layers is there, because we are while talking about the SATCOM also we are talking about the orbits. So similarly, in which layer that we can place that satellite, because again, the depending upon the application that satellite is used to place in a particular working as the space or the layers, okay, in the atmosphere or in the space. If we want the take the example of your the weather forecasting or other for the television or other things for the Navy, for the other things. So totally depend in every atmospheric layer, the other the satcoms will be placed. Okay, so here also in the sky view propagation, the signals will be reflected from the ionized layer of the atmosphere back down to the earth. They move ahead and they are getting back every time. See here, the with the help of this figure, you can identify easily the transmitting antenna as well as the receiving antenna. Two towers are there, and in the ionic sphere, the signal can be go up, then getting down, then going up, then getting down. Likewise, that signals is covering the distance from the transmitting to the receiving antenna, because the directly it's not at all possible. That's why the alternate form is nothing but it will be jumped. This signal will be jumped or go into the ionic sphere, then down, then up, then down, like bouncing every time that the ball. And in this way, we are getting the signals is propagating so that you will receive the proper signals. This is the one way. The signal can be traveled a number of hops back and forth between the ionospheres and the earth surfaces. The reflection effect caused by the refraction, two process. And the example where it is used, the sky wave propagation mode of operation is used in the CB radios. Again, one type of radios and other is nothing but these are the types of the radios. The armature radio. So these are nothing but your the application where these terms are used. Line of the sight propagation, the transmitting and receiving signals. Antennas must be within the line of the sight. Transmitting and the receiving antennas must be within the line of the sight. Okay, the refraction case, bending of the microwaves by the atmosphere, velocity of the electromagnetic waves is a function of the density of the medium. Okay, when the wave will be changes, the medium speed will be the changes, wave bends at the boundary between the mediums. So this such type of line of sight most widely used whenever the heats are there, whenever the rivers are there, whenever such thing where the directly the signals is not at all possible to get from the transmitting station towards the receiving station. That's why we use this line of sight. Okay, so whether we are having a straight or not, by taking the towers high, by taking the length high, and as per that we can identify, and then we can get the type of a signal. In the line of sight, there are various equations how we can find the optical line of sight. That is nothing but how we can find the distance. This is a derived expression. 3.57 is a derived expression, and the root of h, that is nothing but the height, and the effective or the radio line of the sight is nothing but 3.57 kilo in terms of the kilo of height you are taking. So here the height of the antenna, d is the distance between the antenna, that is in the horizon form in the kilometer, and the k is nothing but the adjustment factor, okay, the reflection and all. So that is constant, that is a 4/3. The maximum distance between the two antennas, that is a line of sight, LOS propagation, so d max is equals 2. So if at the one side, the height of the antenna at the one side and height of antenna of the two, if we are having the two antennas, if I having the one antenna, at that time you need to add these two things to get the maximum distance. So line of sight, wireless transmission impairments. So and attenuation, which parameter affect in the line of sight, that is attenuation and attenuation distortion, free space loss, noise, atmospheric absorption, multipath refraction, and the thermal noise. Okay. So next is nothing but the attenuation, what we can say, the strength of the signals falls with a distance over the transmission medium. So attenuation factors of an unguided medium. So received the signals must have the sufficient strength, okay? So signal must maintain the level of sufficiently higher that the noise to be received without error, the noise to be received. Even if we are receiving the noises at the receiving point, then also that should be without the error. Okay, that must be possible to remove that error. So in this situation, the attenuation will be greater at a higher frequency and causing the distortion. So many things will be affected. Few formulas are there, but we will simplify and we will go through that. But the parameter which will be affected while you are finding the losses and the frequency and the, so the signal power at the transmitting antenna, signal power at receiving, the carrier wavelength, the distance between the antennas and the speed of the light. These matters, even the gain of the transmitting antenna, gain of the receiving antenna, the effective aperture at the transmitting and the effective aperture at the receiving point. So these are the basic parameters which are required while you are going to simplify the numericals. Okay. So the GT, GR, AT and the AR, gain and the effective area of the antenna. The category of the noise, because there will be the distortion, interferences of the noise, so thermal noise is there, intermodulation noise is there, crosstalk noise is there, impulse noise is there. You can find many times while you are talking to the someone, might be you have observed many times, there will be the cross connection or the cross signals received to you or maybe the other person. And even though you dialed the correct number, still you will get the cross connection. So this is the one of the interference from the noise, you can say. Okay, so there are a lot of noises are there. What is mean by the thermal noise, which is happened due to the ignition of the electrons and present in the all the electronic devices and the transmission medium, cannot be eliminated. The function of the temperature related to that function of the temperature, particularly significant satellite communication. In such a cases, if devices are electronic, because we know very well the SATCOM is also the transistor, so many components are placed in the SATCOM, even at the transmitting and the receiving ground station or the controlling station, we have a very electronic components. So definitely such noise will be present there. So the amount of a thermal noise to be found with the help of the bandwidth of a 1 hertz in a device or the conductor. So the noise power density in the watt per 1 hertz of the bandwidth, the KT is the watt per hertz. So K is the Boltzmann constant, 1.38, and this is power minus 23 joules per Kelvin, and the T is the temperature. Okay, since we can find the N0. So noise is assumed to be independent of the frequency. So thermal noise of a bandwidth, N is equal to KTB. So if you are able to find all these things, the Boltzmann constant, temperature, and the bandwidth and all, and you are converting into the decibel, because whenever you are talking about the attenuation and all, we are interested in the what we can say, decibel and the number form. So all these things we can substitute 10 log 10 or the 20 log 10. Likewise, already we have studied in the network analysis, the conversion from the nipper to decibel, decibel to nipper, even in the voltage current as well as the power gain while you are going to calculate. The 20 will become in the power, whereas if you're talking about the voltage and the current, it will be the 10 log 10 likewise. So noise terminology, which terms are required, useful or needed. So that is the intermodulation noise that occurs if the signal with a different frequencies having the same mediums. Okay. And the cross unwanted coupling between the signals pass. So these are the examples, the figures, how the things are going on. Okay. That is the first is nothing but the related to the intermodulation noise, and second is the cross connection noise. So noise terminology, again, the impulse noise. So irregular pulses or the noise spikes. Suddenly there will be, so at that time you can say such noise, short duration and of a relative high amplitude. Whenever you are finding high amplitude in such cases, caused by the external electromagnetic disturbances or the faults and the flows in the communication system. Okay, so you can get a such noise in the example of lightning. Okay, in the rainy season and all other impairments, that is atmospheric absorption, water vapors and the oxygen contributes to the attenuation. So multi-path obstacles, reflection, because the hills are there, the rivers are there. So definitely in the while you are finding the parameter of multi-path, so at the time obstacles will be there. Okay, they are varying. Obviously the transmitting and the receiving signals will be delayed in such cases. The refraction, so bending of the in the reflection, bending of the radio waves as they are propagating through the atmosphere, because we have seen the ionospheric, in that reflection is also there, so bending is there, turning tunnels are there. In such cases, this matters. Fading in the mobile environment,
environment. So in such a case, the fading is one of the parameters which affects if the car is passing and the signals are from the transmitting to the receiving. Okay, the various paths are there, but they're changing in the transmission medium or the path. Every time if you are going to change your location, changing every time, so that time the fading is occurs variations in the time every time. Okay, so the signals which is traveling from the one location to the other location, so receiving signals will be delayed. Not only delayed, but there is a variation in the time. Okay, the signals and received signal power will be caused by changing the transmission medium, because the transmission medium is not at the fixed place. This is the portable things, or you can say that car is moving and it's changing its path every time the transmitting and the receiving is the other path every time that there is a change in the transmitting medium. So that's it. The multi-path propagation, that is the NPS. So here in this case, the reflection, diffraction and scattering is an important matter. So what is the reflection occur when the way of the propagation, they are showing the not only the one path is there, there is a multiple path, because in the one side the reflection is going on, in other side the diffraction is going on, in the other side the scattering is going on. Every time the length is changing, okay, the path is changing, the wavelength is changing. So in such a case, this multi-path propagation is important to study over that. The effects of multi-path propagation, so multi-path copies of the signal may arrive at the different phases. If the phase add destructively, the signal level relative to the noise declined, making the detection more difficult, known as a intersymbolic interferences, ISS. So here transmitting pulse, transmitted pulse was transmitting every time, and see here the received loss LOS, the line of sight pulses are there, the received multipath are there, how the spikes we are getting, okay, and all these things we are measuring in terms of with respect to the time period T, okay, the pulses are changing. So what will be the effect? Types of the fadings, so there are various kinds of fadings are there. One is the fast fading, slow fading, flat fading, selective fading, relayed fading, and the recent fading. So these are the fading which will be affect, okay. How they can be affect? Short-term fading means while the one place to the another place, just because of the occurrence, interferences of all, whether that fading is drastically changing, whether they are slow, all this come for what you can say, the losses you can say, and they are measuring with respect to the distances also. How much amount of the pulses are there, how the distance is so far, and as for that only, they will change. So short-term, long-term, okay, and the path losses. Obviously, if delay is there, a lot of delay is there from the transmitting to the receiving signals, so definitely the path will be lost. Okay, in such cases, this we need to again identify how was the fading, whether it was the path, the slow and the medium and whatever, and how you can find the signal strength with respect to the distances, how the frequency, the distance, and the time matters in the fading. So in such a way, I have tried to give the introductory part about the wave propagation. Okay, so this was the chapter number 2 in propagation. We have covered the introductory part radiation. So we have studied the basic concept related to the wave propagation, which are the types of wave propagation, which is required for the design of an antenna for the wave propagation. In this way, I have tried to explain about